If you don't have access to your Facebook account, either because it was hacked or you lost access to the login details like your mobile number, email or password and you'd like to recover it, or if you see a try another device notification when attempting to do so, then this is the right video for you. I also posted a similar video about a month ago explaining how to recover your Facebook account using the new verification method of a video selfie instead of submitting an ID. However, it seems some people didn't fully understand the process or the right steps on how to do it. So today, I'll walk you through a step-by-step guide on how to use this new Facebook account recovery method. But before we start, here is a question from Facebook warning about ongoing hacking tricks. They said, "We have seen evidence of malicious actors sending business manager partner requests that include phishing links. As we investigate this issue, we encourage you to exercise caution, as these notifications come from a legitimate meta domain, and that is facebookmail.com. If you don't know the person or business mentioned in the partner request, do not click on any links." So this is just a warning so that you stay away from such links in order to avoid being hacked. So back to the recovery method. First, ensure that if you're using a mobile device, you have the Facebook app installed and it should not be logged into any account. If it is logged in, you need to log out first. Next, make sure you have a browser that is also not logged into any Facebook account. With these two conditions met, you can proceed with the recovery method. To begin, open your browser. In the search bar, type Facebook Help Center. Once the page is open, you click on Login, Recovery and Security. From there, you click on the search icon and type Recover Account. Next, scroll down and select Recover your Facebook account if you can't access your account email address or mobile phone number. You will then see a link that says, if you suspect your account was hacked, visit facebook.com/hacked. So you click on that link. This will then take you to the report compromised account or what to do if your account has been hacked page, where you'll follow some security steps for account recovery. Before that, you click on the three dots in the top right corner and enable the desktop site option. This will allow you to access the desktop version of the site. And this should open the link in your Facebook app, which is why it's important not to be logged into any account there. In the Find Your Hacked Account section, you'll be asked to enter any mobile number associated with your account. Since you don't have access to this number, choose the option to search by email address instead. Now, if you also don't have access to the email address, enter your Facebook account name, provided that the hacker hasn't changed it. So if it appears, you click on Recover. At this point, you may encounter a try another device error, but I'll explain this later in the video and how to address it. If this error doesn't occur, you click on Recover. Then under Choose a way to recover, select the option for a video selfie, ensuring you are in a well-lit area. First, you'll need to choose a new email address for logging in and receiving notifications. This email address will only be visible to you on your profile, and you can change it at any time. Enter your new email address. So I've noticed that some people report receiving an error message stating, "We can't validate this email address." This usually happens if the email you entered is too new or not very active. So in this case, try entering an older email address that has been active for some time. Once you've entered a valid email address, you click on Continue and a verification code will be sent to that address. Copy the code and paste it into the appropriate field and then continue. Next, you'll select how your selfie is reviewed. You can choose face recognition technology, which is always faster, or opt for manual review, which takes longer. I recommend selecting the face recognition option and then clicking Continue. Now you can start recording your video selfie. Position your face in the designated circle and hold your phone at eye level, ensuring your whole face is visible. Follow the on-screen instructions to turn your head as directed. Once your video selfie is captured, you can submit it. After submission, you'll need to wait a few hours for Facebook to review your video selfie. Once approved, you'll receive a link allowing you to reset your password and regain access to your account. Now, regarding the try another device notification, this typically happens when Facebook doesn't recognize the device you're currently using, perhaps because you're using a new phone, a different computer, or a new network. To fix this, try logging in from a device or browser you've used before. But if that's not possible, try using a network and location similar to your previous login conditions. But I'll keep you updated on more changes, so be sure to subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and see you in the next one.